there as well. She's been covering President Trump's trip to Paris. And interesting, Kate, as we saw all of these world leaders walking together slowly to get that moment, President Trump was not there. Why did he decide to come in by
himself? That's right, because so this morning you saw a lot of the world leaders arriving to meet with President Macron before they arrived at this ceremony today. President Trump was not one of those world leaders. Instead, he came directly here to the Champs-Élysées from the ambassador's residence where he has been staying while he is here in Paris. Instead, opted to...
Cyril speaking here. I wonder if you could talk a little bit about the nature of the ceremony and the fact that it wasn't what Donald Trump had advertised. When he first said he came to Paris a while ago, he had wanted to see a military parade. That's not what's happening today.
That's actually a great point. President Trump had this idea after he visited Paris last year for Bastille Day and saw this grand military procession right here on this street that we're standing near now. That inspired President Trump to have one of his own in Washington. This is something he prompted the Pentagon to start doing. They had a price tag. So many aspects and planning went into this, but when the price tag was so high, President Trump tweeted that he would no longer have that parade. Hopefully the cost could go down next year, though he didn't explain why he believed that would be the case.
From Paris now, CNN White House correspondent Caitlin Collins and CNN's chief White House correspondent Jim Acosta. Jim, about 50 yards from that commemoration ceremony that's taking place right now. Caitlin, I want to start with you. Do we know why the president chose to arrive separately?
Well, that was likely a security concern. They didn't want to put President Trump on a bus with dozens of other world leaders as it made its way down the Champs-Élysées today, but also because President Trump was not with those world leaders beforehand. Instead, he came straight to the ceremony from the ambassador's residence where he has been staying and rode in the Beast, as you just showed, coming down this street here on his way. And that is when that protester jumped over those barricades and got very close, closer than I've ever seen anyone get to the Beast before, in some kind of demonstration, whether she was protesting President Trump or protesting this overall, before she was tackled and apprehended by French security officials. Now, then you did see it was a striking image to see all of those world leaders, the Canadian Prime Minister, the French President, the German Chancellor, all making their way to this ceremony, all side by side, but no President Trump, because he had already arrived and was waiting in the wings for them to make their way to the stage. Another leader who did similar was the Russian President Vladimir Putin, who came up after President Trump had already gotten on stage with the First Lady Melania Trump and shook hands and then took his stage over by the French President's wife. Now, all of this comes as there has been criticism for the White House since they scrapped President Trump's visit yesterday to a cemetery where he's supposed to visit the dead soldiers who are buried there, dead American soldiers. But White House officials are now voicing confidence that that criticism will dissipate after this ceremony ends today and President Trump does go to the Surin American Cemetery, where he's going to not only lay a wreath, but deliver his first formal remarks of the trip.
All right, Caitlin Collins.